Last episode, we discussed model editing. We mentioned that in the mesh's name, the word after the last two underscores is the material name, and that these are defined in the .mdf file. To understand what materials are, I've opened an MDF file using the MDF Manager. We'll get to the setup later. So in this box, we have our materials. We can have more than one. Clicking on HAM050 displays our texture maps on the right and the material properties to the bottom. Under the texture maps, we have our albedo, normal, alpha maps, and more, and each have a path to the texture file location. Under the material properties, we can adjust the emissiveness, the color, and other parameters. Basically, the material defines what the mesh would look like and where the texture files would be. To correctly texture a mesh, you have to do the following. 1. Match the material name in the mesh to the material name in the MDF file, and 2. Define the file path of the texture in the MDF. In this video, we'll begin by using the MDF Manager to edit the MDF for our frying pan hammer, then we'll go over the process of exporting the .28 texture files. Let's begin with the MDF file. Download, extract, and open the MDF Manager. We won't be creating an MDF file, but modifying an existing one. So be sure to create a copy of the original MDF file. Again, in this box is our materials. Currently, we have one, but we could add more by adding more materials to our library over here. So let's select Add. We will select an MDF file that contains the materials we want. So for example, I'll select the light bulb gun MDF here. Clicking on the arrow next to the MDF path reveals the materials under this MDF file. So we can simply choose and drag it to a materials box over here. As mentioned earlier, we have to rename this to match the material name in the mesh. But since you only have one material, we will just go ahead and delete this. Next, let's move on to the texture maps. Since there are a lot of textures to go over, I'll just go over a few. For now, I'll edit only the base dielectric map, or albedo, or our base color map, and the NRMR_NRT map. This provides the bumpiness or roughness texture. Since we are able to specify the texture location, I'll create a folder just for our textures. And we can indicate this in our MDF file. So we can save this and we can return to this later. Monster Hunter Rise uses texture files with the file extension .28. We get these by exporting a .dds file from Photoshop or paint.net, converting it to the MHR Tex Chopper into a .tex file, and then renaming that file with the .28 file extension. Now, paint.net can export .dds files by default, but I suggest you acquire Photoshop instead, since it's, in my opinion, easier to modify color channels. You would have to download and install the DDS plugin for Photoshop. Starting off, let's work on our basic color texture. According to this documentation, the red, green, and blue color channels are for the regular colors, while the alpha would be inverse metallic. So I've opened the texture that came with the model. As you can see, we only have our red, green, and blue channels, so we need to create an alpha channel. Because the pan model also came with a metallic texture, I can just put this into our alpha channel. Going back, because I want this gray region to be shiny, I will invert the colors of the alpha, because again, the higher the alpha value, the less metallic the surface is. Alright, after that, we can export the DDS. File save as. There are specific settings we have to follow depending on the texture. For base colors, or ALBD, we want to use color plus alpha, and in compression, BC7 sRGB DX11. I can press OK. So another thing, these textures dimensions need to be in powers of 2, like 512 by 512 pixels or 1024 by 1024 pixels. Next, we'll work on the NRMR texture. These are used to add bumps or dents to our model without needing to actually sculpt it in the mesh. According to this documentation, the red, green, and blue will be our regular normal map, while the alpha is for roughness. Luckily, we have this roughness texture pre-made for us. So again, let's make an alpha channel and copy-paste that roughness texture into the new alpha channel. So again, let's save this. So let's export this again. We will use color plus alpha and BC7 linear. Press OK. To convert the DDS file to text, we need to use the MHR Tex Chopper. Okay, so I have my DDS files here together with the MHR Tex Chopper. All you would need to do is simply drag the DDS file over the Tex Chopper, go through this warning here. You only need to do this once. And there, we have our text file. With this program, we can also convert text files to DDS. I recommend setting the Text Chopper as the default application for both DDS and text files. Next, append the .28 to the end of the file name of the text file. Okay, now I'll paste these .28 files into the custom texture folder we made earlier. I will also place our modified MDF file here and just rename it. Right, before we install, let's double check the MDF file. Okay, so the only thing we would need to change is the file names over here. Save this, and we should be good to go. Keep in mind, if these files are missing, or if the texture path is incorrect, the armor piece will not load in game, or you will receive a black screen on starting the save file. Similarly, if we have mismatched materials in our MDF file with the model, we will end up having a checkered pattern on the model, or having an invisible model altogether. Alright, so let's install the mod and start the game. Here we have our pan, fully textured, with an albedo and normal map. So this is it for today's episode on texturing. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Next would be sound modding, but I won't get to that till after I make another mod.